How do you see the HR industry maturing in the different segments?
Indian HR industry is 25,000 crore plus, and it's almost one-fifth of the Bollywood industry. So this is how we should look at it, an industry that nobody can ignore now, even though it is not very large, but it's growing rapidly and becoming very, very important. Amongst this segment of 25,000 crore, if you look at it, I look at broadly four buckets. Bucket one, which is led by recruitment for a variety of reasons, but because of the sheer size of the recruitment industry itself. Second category is about the consulting part, which remains very, very important. And you have the big fives and the global players who are playing a very, very important role, and which has been there for a while. So it's a fairly matured industry. The third segment that I look at is in predominantly outsourcing. This whole segment is having employee lifecycle related activities, which are outsourced. And fourth part that I'll pick up from the prominence perspective is the technology. These are four buckets where maximum spend of the client community or the corporations goes and constitutes the large part of the vendor community. If you broadly say that about 20,000 crore out of this 25,000 will go towards recruitment. There are a few segments which are picking up in India and will take a while before they become important. For instance, if you look at benefits industry, which is a big industry globally, in India it's almost negligible. But it is moving in the same direction.
So in terms of the maturity curve, where do you think India is in the HR industry space?
Market competition is directly proportionate to the talent maturity. So as market competition heated up in India, the talent maturity or talent processes or service providers also started maturing. So from the market perspective, readiness perspective, a ground where experimentation can take place, India is far ahead than anyone else and probably topping the charts. But when it comes to depth and innovations, India has a long way to catch up. The investment that Indian community from human resources, be it from the corporate side or the vendor community, is not to that level that US is making. That's how I see it.